На очередь поставил?
На одиночку.
Братан, ты живой?
Он занят.
Чувак, ты живой? Живой? Где ты? С какого ты бата? А? С какого бата? А позывной?
Попробуй-ка ползти к нам.
Попробуй к нам ползти! Чё с тобой? Ты раненый? Я хуёво его слышу. Раненый? Что, рука, нога? Ползи к нам! Ты с какого города? Заебись, я с Москвы! Несы, мы тебе поможем! Несы!
Сука!
Пиздец. Готов? А, блядь.
Нихуя себе.
Пиздец, какие мы злыдни. Сука, мы же его обманул. Смотри, ствол. У него стол в руке был?
Да. Винтовка.
А?
Винтовка в руке у него была.
Serhii Zagorets, Ukrainian military expert, noted that the Ukrainian Defense Forces are conducting offensive actions in the western part of the Glushkovsky district, Kursk region. After our offensive in the Kursk region, Russia gathered forces from various areas and redeployed them a month later. The so-called Russian offensive has been ongoing for 4 days, although it was only active on the first day. We know that the enemy has redeployed troops from different areas to strengthen their presence in the Kursk region, with manpower estimated to range from 30,000 to 60,000. I believe that the figure of 35,000 is quite adequate, said Zagorets on Espresso TV. According to the military expert, Russia tried to unblock the groups trapped in the Glushkovsky district, conducting offensive actions starting from Koronevo to the south. There were clashes near several settlements, but it seems that Russia's potential has been exhausted. Currently, there is information that Ukrainian troops in the western part of Glushkovsky district are conducting offensive actions to enter the rear or cut off the ability of Russian units to exert pressure along this line, starting from Koronevo and ending at Snagost, explained Zagorets. The military expert added that Russia is deploying additional units to the Kursk region. We are talking about airborne assault and airborne units of the Russian Federation, which carried out the main attack 2 days ago. Marine brigades are also being used, but the rest of the Russian troops are a collection of different units. The enemy's main striking forces, airborne and marines, are being actively restrained by our troops, which is causing damage and destroying the forces of these units, emphasized Zagorets. The Institute for the Study of War, ISW, writes that the Russian army continued its counterattack in the Kursk region, but achieved only minor successes, likely due to the continuation of the Ukrainian offensive and defensive actions. ISW military experts note that Russian troops have advanced so far in areas of the Kursk region that Ukrainian forces were not yet fully controlling nor attempting to control, and Russian forces will likely face more difficulty when counter-attacking Ukrainian-controlled territory. The ISW uses the doctrinal definition of control when referring to control of terrain, in which control is a tactical mission task that requires a commander to maintain physical influence over a specific area to prevent its use by an enemy or to create conditions necessary for successful friendly operations. Russian forces have advanced roughly 58 square kilometers in areas where the ISW has observed either maximalist claims or visual evidence of Ukrainian forces operating since starting counterattacks.